add the animation. So we have the cured, pills dropping down, and pills going up and disappearing. Hello everyone, I am Neha Fatima, and today we will be making a very cool floating button animation. I know you guys have been waiting for this. This is a very cool interaction that was also a part of the competition before. So it is very simple, pretty straightforward, and it is really, really fun to do. And after you're done with this interaction, you'll also get an idea of how to, you know, make other interactions, button interactions on Figma as well. So let's not waste any time and dive right into it. I'm quickly gonna share my screen. Okay, so before we get started, let me give you a quick glimpse of what we'll be designing today, what interaction that we'll be making today. So this is a pretty straightforward, simple interaction. So you can see this little button available over here. On click, it expands into a little box and it drops down pills one by one. And when I click back on the cross button, it closes the interaction just as it started. So this is, you know, looks very cool, looks complicated, but trust me, it is not. We are going to be able to make this very quickly, and this is also very fun. So let's get started. So before getting right into the frames and all that, let me give you a quick overview of what Figma is and how, you know, the entire UI works for people who are not aware of what Figma is. So this is the layout how Figma looks, and in the center you have what is called as your canvas. This is where all your elements go. Everything that you design, you go over here. And on the right side we have our properties panel, which consists properties for every single element. So suppose I have a rectangle, it will show me properties of all properties of that rectangle in the properties panel. And on the left side we have our layers and assets panel, where you'll be able to see all of your frames, all of your groups. Every single element that you have in your canvas, you'll be able to see it on the left side. And apart from that, we have our tools bar on the top, which consists of a lot of tools here. You can see the frame tool and slice tool and a lot of shapes, the pen tool, text tool, and a lot of fun stuff over there. So let's dive right into it now. The first thing that we will be doing is making a frame. So I'm just going to head over to my tools bar, select the frame from the drop down, and drag it into my canvas. And let's change the width to maybe about 350 and height to maybe about 260 pixels. Okay, so we have our frame here. What I'm going to do is change the background fill color of my frame. So to do that, again, I'll just have to select my frame, head over to my properties panel on the right side. Scroll down and you can see this fill area over here, which is the fill property. So I'm going to change the fill property to an almost black, dark gray shade and leave it at that. And as you can see, so every interaction has an initial state and a final state. So what we are trying to do is go from the initial to final and then add the animation or the interaction. So you can see this is the final state. This entire frame that you can see with the expanded rectangle and all those three pills aligned properly, this is the final state. So first, what we are going to do is we're trying to achieve the entire UI or the physical elements of the visual elements of the final state. And then we'll go on to making the initial state, and then we'll start interacting. So every time that you are, you know, making an interaction on Figma or making an animation, remember that you have to think of these animations as different states. So it gets a lot easier, you know, when you think of it that way. It doesn't get complicated at all. So let's quickly do that. What we're doing is basically making the final state that I just showed you. So now I'm just going to head over to my toolbar and select my rectangle from here and drag it into my canvas. And again, maybe I'll change the width to 250 and height to maybe 160 pixels. That looks okay. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in a little bit of border radius to it so that, you know, the corners are a little smooth and they don't look very edgy. So I'll select my rectangle, and in the properties panel, you can see all these properties appearing over here. You can see something called as the corner radius over here. This is the corner radius. So we'll be changing that to 25 pixels. 25 looks fine. Okay, so now we have it. The next thing that we'll be doing is we'll be changing the fill color of this rectangle. So I'm going to select it, head over to my properties panel, fill section and change the fill to any color that you like. You can add in any color that you like. I'm just going to take a nice shade of blue. Okay, we've got that. This is a nice shade. Okay, so we have our rectangle and we've added the fill properties, and this much is done and set. The next thing that we'll be doing as per our final state, you can see we have these icons and the text and this little circle with the close and open icon. So that is what we are going to make right now. Okay, so let's quickly head over to the toolbar and select a circle from the drop down, the ellipse, and then I'm going to hold shift on my keyboard and drag it over here and just draw the circle. Okay, so maybe a little smaller would do. 40 pixels would do. So this is here, and yeah, okay, I've got my circle, and now I'm going to change the fill color of it, fill property of it. So I'm just going to select it, head over to my properties panel again, fill section, increase the let's make it a dark gray shade, and then I'm going to decrease the opacity. So over here I'm going to decrease the opacity to maybe about 10% or 40%. 30% will look fine. Yeah, this looks fine. Okay, so we have our little circle over here, just like we saw in the final state. So we've got that. Now we need to make the into a cross button, the close button, right? So I'm just going to make that. So I'm not going to import any icons from plugins for this one right now. I'm just going to normally make this because it's pretty simple. So I'm going to head over to my toolbar and select my rectangle from the dropdown, draw it over here, change the width to maybe about 2 pixels and height about 18 pixels would do. Yeah, okay. So now I'm going to change the corner radius to about 10 to 20 pixels so that it's all, smooth. And we've got that. So we have this here. I'm just going to change the fill property of this again. Select it, head over to your properties panel, fill section. I'm just going to change this to FC, FC, FC. That is the hex code for almost white shade. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this element, this little rectangle, and then change the angle of it, rotate it to 90 degrees so that it looks like a plus icon. Okay, so I'll just copy this. And in the properties panel, you'll be able to see something called as rotation. I'm going to change this to 90. Okay, and I'm going to drag and place this properly. Okay, so we have our little plus icon, and I'm just going to select both of these elements and group them. So to group any element, all you have to do is Control G to group any element, or what you can do is right click and you'll be able to see something called group selection. So you can see all the short keys for it over here, the hot keys. So you can just select, do that, and you have your group. So make sure, another thing that you need to be aware of when you're doing, designs on Figma, or generally designing on Figma, is that all of your elements are inside your frame. So this is my frame one, and you can see that all of my elements, the plus icon, the circle, the rectangle, all of them are inside my frame. They're not outside. So you have to make sure that they are inside your frame, otherwise the interaction will end up not working. So I'm just going to decrease the size a little bit maybe and place it in the center. Okay, so we've got plus icon. And all we need to do now is add in the icons, right? So I am going to use a plugin called Phosphor Icons. So if you do not have this installed in your Figma, what you can do is right click, head over to plugins and click on browse plugins in community. And it will take you to this tab where you can just search for Phosphor Icons. Okay, so Phosphor Icons, and just click on install and you'll be able to use it in your family. Okay, so we have it installed already. So now we can use it in our canvas. I'm just going to head back to my canvas, and here, right click, plugins, and select your Phosphor Icons. And now I'll be needing three types of icons that you can see in the final state, the bookmark, the notes, and the task. So let's quickly get that, all right? Okay. So we have this. I'm just going to search for a bookmark. And here you can also select the type of icon that you're looking for. If you're looking for a filled icon, so I'm just going to select this. And another thing that I need is notes. So click on that and it'll appear on your canvas. And the next thing that we need is our task icon, right? So we've got this too. Okay, so we have our three icons and we are good to go. So we have our icons. Let's just align them properly over here. And maybe they are a tad bit big, so we can decrease the size maybe a little bit, so maybe 28 pixels. Yeah, 28 pixels looks good. So now we have our icons. I'm going to change the fill property of these icons to white so that they look all nice with the blue background. Just select them all. You can also, you can select them all by pressing shift on your keyboard. And another thing you will notice right now is that in the layers panel, these two icons are not inside my frame. So this is something that you constantly need to take care of. So I'm just going to drag them inside my frame. And now you'll be able to see that they're properly aligned. Okay, so now I'm going to select them, head over to my properties panel, fill section, change this to our FC, FC, and FC. So that's a white shade. And now I'll make sure that the distance between each of them is proper. It's about 13 pixels, all right. Now, the next thing that we need to do is again write in our text, and that is it, we'll be good to go. Okay, so I'm just going to add in my text box, head over to your toolbar, select your text box, and I'm just going to write resources. So now you can see in your properties panel, you'll be able to see a lot of other properties appearing when you start using your text box, right? So you can see your typeface, your thickness and font size, and all of these properties. So here I'm using a typeface called Roboto. You can also use anything like Poppin, the Montserrat, or anything that you like. I'm just going to use Poppin here. Let's see. And maybe change it to 18 pixels. Yep, that's good. And maybe I'm going to change the thickness to about medium. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, we've got that. Now instead of, you know, going back to the toolbar again and again and dragging my text box, I'm just going to copy this element because I've changed the properties already. So I'll copy it. To copy an element, again, all you have to do is press Alt and drag. Or what you can do alternatively, if Alt and drag is, you know, you're not comfortable with that, you can just press, select the element and Control D on your keyboard, and you can duplicate this element. Right, so this, I'm going to change this to Notes, and I'm just change this to Task. Okay, so I'm just going to align them with respect to their icons so that they're centrally aligned. And you can then group them together. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select my resources and select my bookmark icon, pressing shift on my keyboard to select both, and then grouping them, Control Z. And then similarly, the rest of the icons as well, I'm doing the same thing, select both elements, Control Z. So now you have group 2, group 4, and group 3. Okay, so we have our group over here. Okay, another thing that you'll notice is that when I select all three of these groups, you'll see another property appearing over here. That is the spacing between each of these elements. So right now it is 13 pixels. So let me go ahead and change that to maybe about 10 pixels. Okay, this looks much better. I'm just going to center it with respect to the frame. And now we have it. Okay, so we have our final state ready. And another thing that we missed out on was making this plus button into a cross mark. So you can see when the text box, the rectangle is open, when the fill is open, you'll be able to see a closing button. So that's what we want. So I'm just going to select this element, that is my group. We can also change the name of this group, but yeah. So select this and head over to your properties panel. And I'm going to change the rotation to 45 degrees, so it looks like a cross mark. Yeah, so we have that. That is done. So we have our mainframe, our final state ready with us. Okay, so how many of you are done with so much? Let me know in the chat box so we can move on further. Great, the page is done. Let me know if you're doing, if you're almost there, if you're halfway there. So let's wait for a minute for everyone to catch up, and then we'll be moving on to the next part. All right. So I hope everyone's following up with me. I hope everyone's designing this, making this interaction with me right now. So if you are, give me a thumbs up. Okay, Vishal is done too. That's amazing. What about the rest of you? I can see a lot of you here, Vipul, Jajwal, Alok. Great, Neha's doing, that's great. Let's get one more yes and then we'll move forward. Okay. Okay, so this, again, the UI part of this element. So here what we are doing again, as I already explained, this final state is what we will achieve first. And after this, what we'll do, you'll see how the entire process goes. You start from the final state and then you take it back to the initial state. So it's all reverse of what you want the interaction to be. So let's get back right to it. All I'm going to do is change the frame name to maybe my main frame so that we don't have any confusion in identifying the same name. I'm going to select it and you can either press Ctrl R on your keyboard to rename it, or you can double tap on this to change the name of this frame. I'm just going to name this main frame. So we have that here. And now what we got to do is basically start from the initial state. That is what you can see on the screen right now. This is our initial state. So let's see how we can achieve that. Okay, so I am going to copy this entire frame. So to copy again, all you can do either Ctrl D or you can use Alt and drag. I'm just going to duplicate this by pressing Ctrl D on my keyboard, and we have this here. I am just going to name this my first frame. Okay, so we have this. Another thing that we can do so that all our elements are centered and we know where each element needs to go, we can use rulers so that your rulers are basically constraints. So you need to maintain a specific margin or a padding in every design that you make, right? So rulers are very helpful in that. So let's do one thing. Let's turn on our rulers and add in some boundaries over here. I'm just going to head over to my main menu over here, head over to your view and select rulers. So you can either head over to your menu and enable your rulers, or you can press Shift R on your keyboard to enable them. And you can see the scale-like thing that appears on the top of your screen and on the left side of your screen. So we have that here. I am just going to drag my rulers and place them just above these, so I know where my elements are supposed to go, so that we don't go beyond the margin. Right, so I am going to copy this main frame again, duplicate it. So Ctrl D, I am going to rename this to 1. And now I am going to do the magic. So here what we are going to do. Again, one thing that you need to remember when you are doing interactions and animations in Figma, that every single frame needs to have matching layers. So now what does that mean? Right, so here you can see our frame 1 and frame main frame. Right, so every single element is same in both of these frames. You can see group 4 to rectangle 1, and then you can see group 4 to rectangle 1. Right, so every single element is same. So in order for the interaction to actually work, all of these frames, every single frame, so if I show you the final interaction, this is a combination of multiple frames, and all of these frames have similar matching layers, which means that all of the groups, all of the elements inside are same, right? So that is what we're doing. So we have this right now. We just want that these elements disappear. They're not seen in the initial frame, right? So I'm just going to select them by pressing Shift on my keyboard, and I'm going to head over to my properties panel. And you can see something called as layer, and you'll be selecting the path to value over here in the dropdown and change this to 0. Okay, so now the elements are not visible. They are the space is 0, so you won't be able to see them anymore, right? So now we, just like in the initial frame, we are not able to see those fills, right? The other thing that we need to accomplish is, minimize this rectangle. So I'm just going to drag it inside over here. Okay, and I'm just going to decrease the size maybe a little bit. Decrease the width to, we have 54 pixels. And maybe I can increase the border radius just a little bit so that it looks a little cleaner, just like a circle. Okay, so looks nice. So what I'll be doing is maybe the background color, just like you can see in the initial frame, you do not have any background. It's just blue. You do not have the overlay that is appearing over here. So I'm going to select it, and the same thing that we did with the filled elements, we are going to head over to our properties panel. Layer section, the pass-through section, just change it to 0%, and there you go. Okay, so we have our initial frame, and another change that we need to do is change this back to 0 degrees, so it looks like a plus icon, right? So select the element, select the group, head over to your properties panel, change the rotation to 0, and here we go. Okay, so we have this over here, and now what we want is that it starts, it magically animates from this frame to that frame. But again, it's not just making the initial and final frame. There are a lot of intermediary frames as well that you'll have to connect. You know, each one you'll have to add animation so that you can achieve the final interact. But it's pretty easy. So let's look into that. Okay, so we have this. So let me know in the chat box if you guys are done with the initial frame, frame one and main frame. Quickly, if you're doing it or you're done with it, great, the page is done. What about the rest of you? Okay, great, great, that's amazing. Okay, so we have our initial frame, that is frame one, and we have our main frame. So now we need to add the bit that is the most important part. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select my frame one and duplicate it again, Control D on your keyboard, and then we have it here, my frame two. And right here, what I want is that when I click on my button, first the rectangle expands and then my pills drop out, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to increase the width or the size of my rectangle back to what it was initially, right? So I'm just going to drag it inside over here, just like it was in the beginning. It was about 250 pixels of width and 170 pixels of height, I guess. Let's confirm by looking into our main frame. Yep, okay, so 160 pixels of height and the border radius is 25 pixels, so we have that here. Okay, so we have this. Let's change the height to properly 160 pixels and the border radius remain 25 pixels, so we have the initial frame. So here, what is going to happen is that when we click on the button, this rectangle is first going to appear and then the pills will start dropping. Also, we need to make this little overlay visible again. So I'm going to select the ellipse, head over to my properties panel, change the pass-through to 100% again. And another thing that I need to do is change this into your close mask, that is your 45 degrees. So I'm just going to select it, head over to your properties panel, change it to 45 degrees. Okay, so we have this here. And now let's try animating this, right? Just the simple first two frames. So I'm going to select my first frame, head over to my properties panel. On the top, you can see design, prototype, and inspect. We are going to head over to prototype and click on interaction. So here you'll see something appearing that says click and none. We'll click on that and make sure, again, one thing that we need to make, keep in mind that over here, we want the interaction to happen on click of this button, right? So this little plus icon, when we click on that, we want the interaction to happen. So I'm going to select this little icon over here and then drag it and then add interaction on click of that particular element. So I'm going to select that and then click on interactions, click on this little icon over here. And then on click, we are going to change the interaction details to on click, navigate to frame two. Okay, and the animation will be smart animate and you can change it to ease out or ease in about 300 milliseconds. Okay, so now let's quickly play this and see how it looks. Okay, so we have our interaction over here. Let's see. You can see that the cursor also changes when you hover over this little button. So when I click on it, you can see that it, you know, expands into a rectangle over there. So yeah, the transition is pretty smooth. We've done great on this. That's great. So now, slowly, what we need to do is basically add on elements one by one. Okay, so another thing that we need to keep in mind that, you know, you saw the pills dropping down one by one. They were not just appearing over there. So that is another thing that we'll be doing over here. So select your elements that, you know, the pills that we had in the beginning of the frame. I'm just going to select them, the pills, and I'm just going to shift them gently a little upwards so that it looks like they are dropping down one by one. So you can see the pass-through is 0% right now, so you can't really see the elements, but if you select it in your layers panel, you'll be able to see how far up they are. Right, so our elements are a little up there, and now we are going to duplicate this frame again. So select your frame 2 and duplicate it. Now we have our frame 3. Now what we want is that every single element, so like we saw over here, resources drops, notes drops, and then cast drops. So every single pill is dropping down one by one. So let's try to get that. Now you'll notice in your layers panel, you can select your resources group 2, and I'm just going to drag it a little down and place it here. And I am going to head over to my properties panel and change the pass-through layer to 100%. So now it will look as if the resources fill is dropping down from this position to this position. So that is why here, even though we can't see this element, we have not enabled the visibility over here. We've made the visibility 0 over here. But you can see that this element is dropping down from that position to this position. Okay. So let's see. Let's quickly see how it looks. So again, what I'm going to do is click on my, select my second frame, and I am going to head over to prototype and click on interactions. And again, this time I am not instigating the interaction on click. I don't want the interaction to happen on click. I just want to click on the button and I want the animation to happen on its own, right? So this animation will be adding it to the entire frame. Here we added the interaction to the little button, but here we are adding the interaction to the entire frame. So I'm going to select frame 2 and add interaction, click on this and change the interaction details to after delay of maybe about 50 milliseconds, we wanted to navigate to frame 3. And then animation again, you can change it to smart animate and ease out in 300 milliseconds. Sounds good. Okay, so now let's see how it looks, right? So we have our initial button here, we click on it, and yeah, you can see the pill dropping, right? That's great. Okay, so let me know if that works, if you're done with this much. If you're with me at this point, we're almost done over here. We need to add 2 more frames and then we will be done. We'll just have to look into how the reverse process happens. So let me know if you're done. You can show thumbs up or type in the chat box. And until then, again, you would have noticed that these pills drop down one by one. So again, just like we did with resources, we'll be dropping down each of these elements. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to send this a little right word, and then I'm going to copy my frame 3. Okay, so duplicate it, Control D. And now, just like we drop the resources downwards, we are just going to select the second element that was our element that was a notes element, and I'm just going to drop it down here and head over to my properties panel in the design section, change the pass through to 100% and make sure that my distance between my elements are also all right. So yeah, it has a distance about 10 pixels. Maybe we can make it a little lesser. Let's have 10 pixels. Okay, so now you will see that your notes will also drop down. So similarly, just like we added the interaction for the frame 3, frame 2 to frame 3, the same way we'll be adding the interaction to frame 3 to 4. So select your frame, head over to your properties panel, click on interactions, head over to your interaction details, and then after delay of about 50 milliseconds, we will change this, navigate to frame 4, and animation will be smart animate. Okay, the same way. So now again, if you look at it, you can see that both the pills are dropping down. similarly, again, we will copy our duplicate our frame 4. We have our frame 5, and the same way we are going to drop down our last fill as well. Select it, head over to your properties panel, change the pass through to 100%, drop it down, and yeah, we've got it, right? And now we need to add the interaction. So select it, properties panel, prototype section, click on interaction, change the interaction details to after delay, same old rule, 50 milliseconds, navigate to frame 5, and animation will be smart animate and ease out in 300 milliseconds. So now we have our interaction almost ready, right? So let's take a look at that. Click, drop, 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 done. So now what we want is that when we click on this, it goes back in its initial way. It basically goes, the fills also revert back to their original positions, and then the rectangle is contracted, right? So let's try achieving that. Okay, so before that, another thing, let's wait for a minute or two so that you all catch up, and let me know in the chat box if you're done with this much. Give me a thumbs up if you're ready to go to the reverse process. Okay, so this is done. So again, just like we started the animation from the beginning till the main frame, right? We are going to reverse engineer this thing actually. So we'll just go back from main frame to back to our first frame. So again, another thing, there's an option, a feature in Figma that you can add interaction, and you know, there's an option called back. So, you know, the interaction goes back to its original frame. But then again, this interaction, it won't happen the same way because you saw how the fills are dropping down one by one, right? So it'll be very difficult to animate that on its own. So we'll have to create another set of frames so that it reverts back in its, you know, proper flow. So let's get right back to it then. Now we have our main frame. I'm just going to select this frame and, you know, add the same interaction over here and change this to after delay of about 50 milliseconds. Smart animate, ease out. So we are good to go with this. Let's take a look. Okay, so we have our frame ready over here. Let's take a look at the interaction that we made, and then we'll be heading over to the reverse animation. Okay, so you can see a slight change in the spacing or the positioning of the frame. So what we can do, we can center all elements together. I think the centering of elements has been hindered a little bit somewhere. So anyway, we can remove the main frame because we have our final state over here. So I'm just going to get rid of this one, and we have our final state over here. So click on it and drop, 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 done. So now we need to reverse back. So I'm just going to select this frame, duplicate it, bring it down here. And yeah, what I'm going to do is, again, just like you saw the pills dropping, we want the pills to, you know, go up and then disappear. So I'm just going to select my task, just take it slightly upwards so that, you know, it looks like the pills are disappearing, going on top and then disappearing. So I'm just going to drag it a little on top and then head over to my properties panel in the design section. Again, change the layer pass through to 0%. And now, same way that we added interactions, for the rest of the elements, we'll be doing it here as well. What we'll have to do is basically, again, now what we want is that when we click on the close button, the entire contraction process happens, right? So we will select our close button over here and add interaction to it. So head over to your properties panel, prototype section, interaction, and then on click, navigate to frame 6. And then the animation will be smart animate, and it will be ease out and 300 milliseconds. So we have got that covered, right? So let's take a look at how it looks. Okay, I think the tab is reloading again. Okay, so we have this, and yeah, you can see it opens up, the pills drop down. When I click on it, it reverts back, right? So we want that to happen with every single element. So I'm just going to copy this frame, duplicate it, Control D, and then I'm going to drag it towards this side so the positioning is nice. And again, same thing we'll be doing with notes and resources. So I'm just going to select my notes fill and drag it upwards and head over to my properties panel on the right side. In the design section, I'm just going to change the pass through to 0% again. Okay, so we have that ready over here. And now the same thing, we'll be adding the interaction over here as well. So we have this ready. So now I'm going to select the frame 6 and then I'm going to head over to my properties panel and click on prototype, interaction, click on after delay and change this to about 50 milliseconds and change this to navigate to frame 7 and this will be again smart animate. So it will revert back over here. Same way, we're going to copy this again and place this element over here, and we need the same thing to happen with the resources fill as well. So I'm just going to select it and drag it a little upward, and now I am going to do the same thing, head over to my properties panel, design section, change the pass through to 0%, and again select your frame 7, prototype, interaction, change interaction details to after delay 50 milliseconds, navigate to frame 8. Okay, so now we have this interaction almost ready. Okay, so I click on it, fill the top down, click back on it, fill disappear, that's great. So now the last step that is left is we need to connect this frame to the initial frame, right? So I'm just going to select this frame, and again, very straightforward, just like we added interaction to the rest of the frame. Select it, click on interaction, and we will change this to after delay of about 50 milliseconds, navigate to frame 1. Okay, so again, animation will be smart animate and 300 milliseconds. So this we have it ready over here. Now let's take a look at the animation. So we have this here, fill dropping down, and fill going up, and this here. Great, so we have our animation done and dusted ready in just a couple of minutes. So I hope you're all done with it. Let me know in the chat box. Give me a thumbs up if you're done with it. So this is the interaction. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Looks a little tough, but then when you actually get to doing it, it doesn't seem that tough, right? So let me know if you are done. How many of you have already done this interaction with me? And if you have any doubts, please leave them in the chat box so that we can get them cleared. Okay, great. So this is done. That's it. That's it, Akash. What about the rest of you? Let me know if you're done, if you're doing it, if you got stuck somewhere. So this is the complete interaction that you can see on my screen, the button animation, floating button animation that you can see. Thank you so much for joining everyone. We'll be wrapping it up right now. And for the people who are watching us right now on YouTube, thank you so much for joining. Please like, share, and subscribe, and let us know in the comments whether or not you like it. Thank you so much.